فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My beloved brothers and sisters, today inshallah ta'ala, and as it should be a characteristics of the believers, I'm going to be as direct and as honest and sincere to you all, inshallah ta'ala. And this topic, I find it a reality we have not yet come to understand. A lot of us are living different to the reality. Every now and then I receive emails. I get calls. And I receive emails and calls from our brothers and sisters, our youngsters, our youths, your children. And then I come across the parents and I look at how they are and their situation. And I see that the child and the parents are on two different waves. They are on two different paths. It's as though the parents haven't yet understood there's a responsibility on them. That is what I'm trying to say. Al-Imam Muslim rahimahullah, he brought in his sahih. In Kitab al-Iman, min hadithi Ma'qal ibn Yasar radiallahu ta'ala an. ما من عبد يسترعيه الله راعية يموت يوم يموت وهو غاش لراعيته إلا حرم الله عليه الجنة. There is not a person Allah places responsibility on his or her shoulder, and they come and they have forsaken that responsibility, except Jannah has been made haram from them. Responsibilities have been placed on each and every one of you. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala made you responsible for these children. Your children are selling drugs. Your daughters are committing zina and you still haven't woken up to the responsibility on you. Allah is going to ask you the day of judgment, كُلُّكُمْ رَاعٍ وَكُلُّكُمْ مَسْؤُولٌ عَنْ رَعِيَتِي. Everyone is responsible and everybody is going to be asked for that which has been made responsible of. When are we going to wake up and smell the coffee? When are we going to wake up and realize the reality? Our children are long gone, they're going every day as it goes by. And we're not yet realizing that we have to get hold of them. And how can we do that? And نؤسس بيوتنا, we have to establish our households in the correct manner. أَفَمَنْ أَسَّسَ بُنْيَانَهُ عَلَىٰ تَقْوَىٰ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانِ. The person who builds his house upon piety and God consciousness, is he like the one who doesn't? The poet, he said, أَلْقَيْتَهُ فِي الْيَمِّ مَكْتُوفًا وَقُلْتَ إِيَّاكَ أَنْ تَبْتَلَّ بِالْمَاءِ. You tied your child, it's as though you take a person, you tie them from the hands and you throw them into the ocean or the sea. And you say to them, be careful, don't let the water touch you. You're the ones who brought these children into this country. And now you want them to not fall into the traps and the plans and the plots of this land and these people. And you haven't prepared him for it. You haven't educated him. Our Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam, he took this responsibility serious. He made sure his companions, they were nurtured correctly. Look at what he said, salawatullahi wasalamu alayhi, to the noble companion Abdullah ibn Abbas. Ya ghulam, إني أعلمك كلمات احفظ الله يحفظك احفظ الله تجده تجاهك إذا سألت فاسأل الله وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله واعلم أن الأمة لو اجتمعوا على أن يفعوك بشيء لم يفعوك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله لك وإن اجتمعوا على أن يضروك بشيء لم يضروك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله لك عليك رفعت الأقلام وجفت الصحف. Our messenger teaches this noble companion, Ya Ghulam, oh young boy. He didn't take him as though he's a little child. He took him responsible and he made sure he taught him and he educated him. My beloved brothers and sisters, the house is, it's labinatul mujtama. It is the foundation of a society. If you want to know a society is corrupt, a society is finished, just look at their household. The household is like the heart. Ala wa inna fil jasadi mudghah. إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله ألا وهي القلب. The messenger said, in the human there's an organ, and if this organ is not taken care of and it's not observed, then the whole of the body of the person will become corrupt. As the poet said, وكل إناء بالذي فيه ينضح. Every vessel will only sweat what's inside it. A society will only produce what they bring up in their own households. Allah says in the Quran, trying to show us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the household is a place where we need to find tranquility. But a lot of us don't find tranquility in our own households. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِنْ بُيُوتِكُمْ سَكَنًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِنْ جُلُودِ الْأَنْعَامِ بُيُوتًا تَسْتَخِفُونَهَا يَوْمَ ضَعْنِكُمْ وَيَوْمَ إِقَامَتِكُمْ وَمِنْ أَصْوَافِهَا وَأُوبَارِهَا وَأَشْعَارِهَا أَثَاثًا وَمَتَاعًا إِلَى حِينٍ وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِمَّا خَلَقَ ظِلَالًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ أَكْنَانًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ سَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمُ الْحَرَّ وَسَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمْ بَأْسَكُمْ كَذَلِكَ يُتِمُّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُسْلِمُونَ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينُ يَعْرِفُونَ نعمة الله ثم ينكرونها وأكثرهم الكافرون. In this verse Allah تبارك وتعالى He tells us والله جعل لكم من بيوتكم سكنا. Allah makes your household a place of tranquility. Do we find our households as a place of tranquility? The answer for many of us is no. And why? It's because you've made your household more corrupt than the streets. You've brought a 50-inch plasma television and you make your child watch it 24/7 and his brain is being programmed as days go by and you're living with haram income that comes into your house. And so then you want a child to come out pious and God-fearing. The messenger told us in the hadith, رَجُلُ يُطِيلُ السَّفَرْ أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَرْ يَمُدُّ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ يَا رَبْ وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ وَغُضِيَ بِالْحَرَامِ فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لِذَلِكِ. A man who's a traveler, he travels from one land to another and he keeps, and then finally he goes through a hard time. He lifts his hands up and he says, Ya Rab, my Lord, take me out of the hardship I'm going through. And then Allah says, he eats haram, he drinks haram, he was raised upon haram. How can this man's dua be accepted? My beloved brothers and sisters, we have to realize the seriousness of our matter. We are living in a time and a place, trials and tribulations are coming to us from every direction. We need to take the precautions that are needed from us. And that is what my topic is about. Our household, for it to be in accordance to how Allah wanted for us to be, for us to live in happiness, the following things are needed from us. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, as Imam al-Tabarani narrated in his Mu'jam, Al-Awsat, and he also narrated it in his Sagheer and his Musnad al-Shamiyyin, that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, طُوبَى لِمَنْ مَلَكَ لِسَانَهُ وَوَسِعَهُ بَيْتُهُ وَبَكَى عَلَى خَطِيئَتِهِ. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in this hadith, prosperity and good be for the one who governs his tongue, whose house suffices him, and he cries upon his sins. How could your house suffice you? And how could your house be a place where you find joy and happiness in? We're going to mention it. The Messenger also told us, سَلَامَةُ الرَّجُلِ فِي الْفِتْرَةِ أَنْ يَلْزَمَ بَيْتَهُ. The Messenger said, a person to find safety from the times of trials and tribulation is for him to stay in his household. It's to stick in your household. So why is it that a lot of us don't find that? It's the following reasons. The first one is, أَنْ نُؤَسِّسَهَا عَلَى تَقْوَى مِنَ اللَّهِ. That we build our households in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of us, we bring in our households things that we don't need and we have no haja for. Excessive things. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or before that, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said to us, وَلَا تُبَذِّرْ تَبْذِيرًا إِنَّ الْمُبَذِّرِينَ إِخْوَانُ إِنَّ الْمُبَذِّرِينَ كَانُوا إِخْوَانَ الشَّيَاطِينَ وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِرَبِّهِ كَفُورًا. The Messenger told us, don't be from those who are excessive. You bring into your household things you don't need. You're placing curtains on the wall and your children are in more need. The sad reality is that people will spend more money in decorating the house, but when it comes to the Quran classes and the madrasa, they will delay. They will delay the madrasa money. They won't pay. The teacher will be asking for it. It will be prolonged. But they will be decorating the house and make sure that the house or the riding beast looks good. One of the ways is to marry a righteous wife, a woman who's going to help you raise righteous children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأَنْكِحُ الْأَيَامَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّالِحِينَ مِنْ عِبَادِكُمْ وَإِمَائِكُمْ. Allah says, marry the righteous ones from amongst you. Because the righteous one is the one that's going to help you. The Prophet said, الدُّنْيَا مَتَاعُ. This world is a very short joy. وَخَيْرُ مَتَاعِهَا الْمَرْأَةُ الصَّالِحَةُ. And the joy of this world is to find a righteous wife who's going to help you. The Messenger said, تُنْكَحُ الْمَرْأَةُ. A woman is married لِأَرْبَعٍ, for four things. لِمَالِهَا, her wealth. وَلِحَسَبِهَا, her lineage. وَلِجَمَالِهَا, her beauty. وَلِدِينِهَا, and her religion. فَاظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَاكَ. Hasten to the one who has religion. If you marry a woman who doesn't fear Allah, why do you expect her to fear you or to listen to you? If she doesn't listen to Allah and she doesn't follow Allah's commands, then why would you expect for her to listen to you? That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لِيَتَّخِذَ أَحَدُكُمْ قَلْبًا شَاكِرًا. That one of you should take a heart that remembers Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, a gratitude. Make your heart a place you remember Allah. وَلِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا. And make your tongue a thing you remember Allah excessively on. And also, وَزَوْجَةً مُؤْمِنَةً تُعِينُ عَلَى أَمْرِ الْآخِرَةِ. And marry a woman who's going to help you in the affairs of the hereafter. A woman who's not going to push you to make haram income. She's going to help you make sure that you get halal. وَلِذَلِكَ سَلَفُ هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ. Their pious predecessors, their wives would always remind them before they left, fear Allah in what you bring home today. Don't bring us what's haram. Two things is what Allah mentioned tranquility should be found in. I said the ayah before, وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُم مِن بُيُوتِكُمْ سَكَنًا. Your house is a place of comfort. And your wife should be a place of comfort or an individual of comfort. وَمِنْ آيَاتِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. So you're meant to find two sakinas, two tranquilities. One should be your house and one should be your wife. But why is it the two are not working correctly? Then that means something is going wrong. What is it that's going wrong? The reason is because we haven't built our household upon piety. وَلِذَلِكَ the rights that the children have on you from them is that you marry you make their mother a righteous woman. When you're marrying, one of the rights that the children have on their parents is that their parents are both righteous. The mother has rights and the father has rights. I have a right on my father that when he was getting married, he should get married to a righteous woman. So then my mother can be a righteous woman. It's haqq min huquq al-awlad. It's a right from the rights of the children that they have on you. One of the things, my beloved brothers and sisters, that we find that's not fulfilled in the house is Allah's remembrance is dead. Allah is rarely remembered. And the believer's tongue is excessively in remembrance of Allah. That's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he praised those who remember him. He said, وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Allah also says, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, مَثَلُ الْبَيْتِ الَّذِي يُذْكَرُ اللَّهُ فِيهِ وَالْبَيْتِ الَّذِي لَا يُذْكَرُ اللَّهُ فِيهِ مَثَلُ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ رَوَاهُ مُسْلِمٌ. The house in which Allah is remembered and the house which Allah is not remembered is a place where it's either dead or alive. The place where Allah is remembered. So do you remember Allah in your household? Or does rarely Allah come on your tongue? One of the things that the Prophet ﷺ told us to do is what? That the man should pray his nawafil, voluntary prayers in the house, and go to the masjid to pray the jama'ah. So the voluntary are done in the house. Why? So the house cannot be maqabir, graves. One of the ways to remember Allah is when you leave the house to make your dua. You say, Bismillahi توكلت على الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And Imam Abu Dawood narrated this. And that the person says also, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an adhilla aw udhalla aw azilla aw uzalla aw adhlim aw udhlam aw ajhal aw yujhal alayya. And Imam Abu Dawood narrated this. Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إذا دخل الرجل بيته, if a person enters his house, فذكر الله, and he remembers Allah عند دخوله, when he enters it, وعند طعامه, and when he's eating food, قال الشيطان, the shaytan says, لا مبيت لكم ولا عشاء. Today there's no place to stay, and there's no food to eat. But a lot of us, our households, is a place where we invite the shayateen. And so then we wonder why our relationships and our wives were separating. Shaytan lives with us, we feed shaytan. He sleeps in our house. The messenger said that shaytan would say, if the person makes the dua before he enters the house, shaytan would say, لا مبيت لكم ولا عشاء. وإذا دخل, if the person enters the house, فلم يذكر الله عند دخوله, قال الشيطان أدركتم المبيت. But if the person doesn't remember Allah when he enters the house, shaytan says, today we have a place to stay. وإذا لم يذكر الله عند الطعام, and if he doesn't remember Allah when he's eating his food, the shaytan says, أدركتم المبيت والعشاء. Today we have food to eat, and we have somewhere to sleep. The Muslim remembers Allah before he goes to sleep. Before he goes to sleep, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us in the hadith of Bara ibn Azib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, قال لي رسول الله, the Messenger said to me, إذا أتيت مضجعك Bara, if you come to your bed, فتوضأ وضوءك للصلاة, do a full wudu, ثم اضجع على شقك الأيمن, then lie on your right side, وقول, and then say, اللهم أسلمت نفسي إليك ووجهت وجهي إليك وفوضت أمري إليك وألجهت ظهري إليك رحبة ورغبة إليك لا ملجأ ولا منجا إلا إليك آمنت بكتابك الذي أنزلت وبنبيك الذي أرسلت واجعلهن آخر ما تقول. متفق عليه. And the person makes this dua, and the Prophet said, make this the last thing which you say before you go to sleep. And then when the believer wakes up, he says in his waking up, Alhamdulillah الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور. Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated it من حديث حذيفة بن اليمان. And then the believer says, when he wants to have a relationship with his wife, he says, اللهم جنبنا الشيطان وجنب الشيطان ما رزقتنا. The messenger told us that if a person makes that dua, shaytan will not touch you, him, and anything from his lineage that comes from it. Then when the believer goes to the toilet, he says, اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبائث. وإذا خرج, when he leaves, he says, غفرانك. رواه أبو داود والترمذي. That when the person leaves the masjid, sorry, they leave the toilet, they say غفرانك. And when they enter it, they say, اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبائث. متفق عليه. A house that's remembered Allah, shaytan is far from that house. It's protected house. No one's going to be possessed. No one's going to suffer. It's a house that's fully looked after. Then we're going to be making sure that we're raising the right children. Also, my beloved brothers and sisters, is that أن نطهر من المخالفات الشرعية. Get rid of things that are haram in the household. From the things that are haram in the household is اتخاذ التصاوير. Placing pictures in the household. Placing and putting pictures in the house. وتعليقها على الجدران. And placing it on the walls. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us, لا تدخل الملائكة بيتا فيه كلب ولا تصاوير. متفق عليه. The angels do not enter a house where a dog is in and there are pictures. The Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, إن أصحابها, the Prophet said to her, he said it to his wife Aisha, إن أصحاب هذه الصور يعذبون يوم القيامة يقال لهم أحيوا ما خلقتم وإن الملائكة لا تدخل بيتا فيه الصور. The Aisha said that the Prophet said to her, the people who drew these pictures are going to be severely punished the day of judgment. And it will be said to them, give life to that which you have created. And verily the angels, they do not enter the houses where there are pictures in it. The other thing is, al-ikhtilat, free mixing. داخل البيوت, in the household. And one of the biggest problems that you find, our cousins are free mixing. And then people say, haram had occurred from this. إخواني الاختلاط بين الرجال والنساء, men and women free mixing in a household where you're trying to raise your children correctly. Wallahi, it is something that its awaqib, its fine outcomes are really not loved. And they are very harmful. The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, إياكم والدخول على النساء. Stay away from entering onto the women and men and women free mixing. فَقَالَ رَجُلٌ مِّنَ الْأَنصَارِ A man from the people of Ansar, he said, أَفَرَأَيْتَ الْحَمْوَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ What about the relative? Her in-laws. What about the in-laws? Like my brother, to my sitting with my wife by herself. The hamu is aqaribu zawj. The Prophet said, Alhamu al-maut, he's death. He's the least expected individual. Now somebody may say, Wallahi, my brother, I know him, he's very trustworthy and he's reliable. And I also trust my wife. I also do. And I trust my wife and I trust my brother. But I don't trust shaitan. That's the one we don't trust. He's the one who's going to cause this problem. So our concern is not necessarily the individuals. It is shaitan who will never give up, who will love to bring harm. And wallahi, brothers and sisters, the emails that I read and the things that I hear of are people who are coming to households and they're free mixing with your daughters and they're sitting with your wives and then the awaqib that come out of you, you complain about it. Ikhwani, as I say always, I'm saying it again. The sharia came to saddu dhara'i'. Our religion doesn't just cure problems. It prevents the problem from coming. It makes sure it puts obstacles in place. It told you, don't look at women. It didn't say to you, don't commit zina. That's why Allah said, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا Don't get close to zina. He didn't say, don't do zina. There's a difference. What does it mean, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا Don't do anything that would lead to zina. So if you're playing around the edges, and then later you fall into the deep end, it's your problem. إِنَّ الْحَلَالَ بَيِّنٌ وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامَ بَيِّنٌ وَبَيْنَهُمَا أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَاتٌ لَا يَعْلَمُهُنَّ كَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ فمن اتقى الشبهات فقد استبرا لدينه ومن وقع في الشبهات وقع في الحرام كالراعي يرعى حول الحمى يوشك أن يرتع فيه ألا وإن لكل ملك حمى ألا وإن حمى الله محارمه ألا وإن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله ألا وهي القلب Brothers and sisters, we're over and we're tired of solving problems. We want to prevent problems. We want to prevent the illnesses before it come. We don't want to just take medicine. We don't just want to go to doctors. We want to live healthy. We want to make sure we don't need to go to the doctors. Prevention is better than cure. Prevention is better than cure. So make sure that the person who comes into your house, he goes to the men's side. And the woman that goes, she goes to the female side. Segregate everybody. Protect your households. And then inshallah ta'ala, jeel, fareed. A generation, a group of people who are righteous are going to come out from that household. The messenger also, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "La yadkhulanna rajulun bimra'atin illa ma'a dhi mahramin." A man should not enter onto a woman unless there is a mahram of hers with her. I'm away. My brother comes to my house. I'll tell him when I come, you can come to my house. If I'm not there, you're not going to go to my house. Hada deenullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cousins will come up to you and say, I was raised with you. I was always your cousin. Na'am, shar'ullahi. The religion of Allah is more beloved to me. Ikhwani, our salvation, our prosperity is connected to following these rules. Allah says about the believers, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتْ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا بَعِيدًا إخواني, these are awamir. The believer is known. إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا The believer is known. If he said, come, Allah said, Come, the messenger said. He says, I hear and I obey. You know why he would say, I hear and I obey? Because he knows if he's looking for happiness. He knows if he's looking for salvation. He knows if he's looking for good, it's in the laws of Allah. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَ وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى You're going to live a hard life when you go against Allah's command. And we're seeing it. We're reaping those dry, those hard, painful fruits because of our own actions. Ikhwani, protect your children. Protect your children. Observe what your children are doing. Look at their issues. You're buying your child a mobile phone. You're buying your daughter a laptop, your son a laptop, and you're letting them be as they want. You're not observing what they're up to. You're not looking at what they're doing. Where's your responsibility? What Allah has placed over you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reason I'm speaking, brothers, is because of the pain that I feel and the things that I come across every single day. We have to wake up. We have to realize what we need to do as Muslims. Wake up. Our issue is in our own hands if we solve it. And to follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد آخر الأنبياء في الدنيا عصرا وأجلهم يوم القيامة شأنا وذكرا صلى الله وملائكته والصالحون من خلقه كما وحد الله وعرف به ودعا إليه أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, one of the things that we're suffering for, why our households are not well, is because hajrul qira'at al-Qur'an, the recitation of the Qur'an is not on. We've exchanged it with music. We're putting on music in our households. And we've left off putting on Qur'an, the statements of Allah, the words of Allah. We've left the Qur'an, all of it generally. And especially Surah Al-Baqarah. We've left the Qur'an ammatan, and we left Surah Al-Baqarah khasatan. Specifically, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, their household was a place which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's words were reverberating and it was coming out. ولذلك the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us, لا تجعلوا بيوتكم مقابر, don't make your household graves. إن الشيطان ينفر من البيت, الشيطان runs away from my house. التي تقرأ فيه سورة البقرة, a house where سورة البقرة is recited, شيطان runs away. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also said, اقرأوا سورة البقرة في بيوتكم فإن الشيطان لا يدخل بيتا يقرأ فيه سورة البقرة. The Prophet said, read سورة البقرة in your households, for verily Shaytan does not enter a house where سورة البقرة is recited. Also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إن الله تعالى كتب كتابا قبل أن يخلق السماوات. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he wrote in a book before he created the samawat and before he created the ard, bi alfay amin, 2000 before it. Wa huwa 'inda al-'arshi, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala was at the throne. Wa innahu anzala fihi ayatayn, Allah sent down two verses. Khatama bihima surat al-Baqarah, in which he concluded surat al-Baqarah with. Wa la yuqra'ani fi darin, these two verses are not recited in a house. Thalatha layalin, 3 nights. فَيَقْرَبُهَا الشَّيْطَانُ, and then Shaytan comes close to that house. The last ayat of Surah Al-Baqarah, آمن الرسول, those 3 verses are not recited in a house 3 consecutive nights, except Shaytan will never come close to that house, let alone those family becoming possessed. So now do we ask ourselves a sincere and honest question? And that question is that have we followed, let alone all of that, but some of that, for us to think to ourselves that we've done our jobs and this is in the hands of Allah, that why our children are not guided. I also want to speak to all you youngsters. Fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, it is not a justification because of your parents. Wallahi, you're going to be brought in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the day of judgment. And you're going to be questioned for every single statement you said. You will be questioned for everything you looked at. You will be questioned for every single thing which you have listened to. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala privately and publicly. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us that the day of judgment there's going to come a group of people. They are going to be coming to Allah and all of their actions will be eradicated. Everything, null and void. Their righteous actions. So when the companions were told this, they said, Ya Rasulullah, ala yusallun? These people, were they not praying? Were they not fasting? Were they not coming with righteous actions? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, yes, they did. ولكنهم إذا خلوا بمحارم الله انتهكوها. But the problem was with them was that when they were private and they had their laptops and they were alone and no one could see them, they did every filthy thought that came to their minds. And because of that, they lost a lot of righteous actions. Youngsters who are using Facebook, Instagram and social media, Allah can see you subhanahu wa ta'ala. يستخفون من الناس ولا يستخفون من الله وهو معهم إذ يبيتون ما لا يرضى من القول. If you're hiding this from your father, if you're hiding this from your brother, if you're hiding it from somebody you fear or you're concerned about from from the community. Remember, you're making Allah, the worst, the one that looks at you. You're respected in human's eyes from not seeing you do these filthy things or speak in this filthy manner. But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, you make him what? Ahwanun nadhirina ilayk. The lowest of those who look at you. Have shyness of Allah. Have concern of him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Youngsters, you have a life ahead of you. Make sure you benefit from this opportunity you have. Life doesn't repeat itself. You don't get this chance again. And once it goes, you're not going to receive it. Fill this, mashallah, smart brain of yours which you have. Fill it up with the remembrance and the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's going to come a day, wallahi, in which you're going to look back and you're going to regret it. And I always remind myself and I say to myself that every single person is going to taste from the bitterness of the cup of death. Everyone will, regardless of who you are, and regardless of how high you are, and regardless of how rich you are, and how blessed you are, you're going to taste the cup of death. Everyone. It's just that we're all in a line, and some people are tasting it before others. But every single one of us is going to taste that cup. Just make sure that when it comes to you that day which you have to taste it and which you have to die, make sure you have died and you have come with righteous action, because you have nothing else to befriend you. This individual that you're hanging around with, this friend that you think he's your boy, he's your homie, he's your man, he's whatever he is for you, wallahi, he's the first one who's going to forsake you in this world, and wallahi, he's going to forsake you in the day of judgment for sure. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ. Your friends are going to run away from you. Even right now, if you look at them, they run away from you. If you committed a crime, the police caught you red-handed doing that crime, they will never say to the police officer, let me take the charges for him. They will forsake you and they have nothing to do with you. إِذَنْ أَلْمَرْءُ عَلَى دِينِ خَلِيلِهِ فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَحَدَكُمْ مَنْ يُخَالِلُهُ. You're of the religion of your friend. Look at who you befriend. A lot of the youngsters, they believe this person is sincere for you. Wallahi, they are with you for nothing except what they can receive from you. The only friend that you have, as I was saying, the only friend that you have is your actions. The Prophet said, يَتَّبِعُ الْمَيِّتُ ثَلَاثَ. You know what a friend is? What is the true meaning of a friend? The ones that's with you through thick and thin. Isn't that what a friend is? That's what your actions are. It will stay with you when everything else leaves you. يَتَّبِعُ الْمَيِّتُ ثَلَاثَ. Three things will go with you to the grave, and they would. Two are going to go back, and one is going to go inside the grave with you. What is the one that's going to go in the grave with you? Your actions. That's the only friend that you have. Make sure you look after that friend. Make sure you accumulate so much righteous deeds. How can you come with righteous actions? Just two things. Memorize that. If you haven't understood all the parts of the khutbah, just remember these two. What are they? Come with righteous actions and stay away from what you're prohibited from. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وأقم الصلاة.